I think it's a great benefit to patients for it to be in Birmingham because of the infrastructure that we have here to manage their care. Radiotherapy is one part of the spectrum of treatment of cancer. You need the very best of all of the parts of the spectrum in order for patients to survive well and to survive with a good quality of life afterwards. And that means you need the best surgery, the best chemotherapy and the best radiotherapy all working together from one team that can really look after the needs of the patient. The patients need this facility to be easy for them to access, and they need the facility to be at the disposal of the best clinical teams. Bringing proton therapy into the NHS is not an easy thing to do. You could do it in a way which involves a whole new clinical infrastructure somewhere else. That would be too complicated. The facility should go where the patients are and where the clinical strength is. So there should be one in Birmingham. It's brand new. When you're first confronted with the scale of the engineering that's required to deliver a proton therapy facility, it's quite awe-inspiring. But at the end of the day, for the patient, the treatment room won't look that different from the one that's behind me. Slightly larger, slightly different, but the staff will be the same. The care that we give the patient will be the same. So hopefully for the patient, it will be as pleasant an experience as radiotherapy ever can be. Accelerator developments started in Birmingham. The original physics behind both the synchrotron and much work on the cyclotron was done in Birmingham. Some of the first, actually it wasn't the first cyclotron in the world, but it could have been if it hadn't been for the Second World War interrupting the program. But one of the first cyclotrons was in the University Physics Department in Birmingham. And they're still running cyclotrons now, producing radioisotopes for medical use around the country. So the heritage is strong. One of the biggest things that I found, and I've actually been quite surprised and pleased as we've gone through the process of engaging people around Birmingham and around this hospital and then going wider, is the enthusiasm for this project, particularly from this trust and from the Children's Hospital and the clinical groups, the clinical specialists really, are very, very enthusiastic to bring what they see as the best standard of treatment for their patients to this city. It'll be a great place for patients to come to. I mean, nobody ever wants to go to hospital, do they? But, you know, if you're going to come, you want to come into a nice environment. It will be a great attractor for the best staff as well. And that's also critical for the proton therapy bid. We're going to be relying on teams of cancer specialists around the country bringing their patients and bringing all of the information to us and having their judgment, if you like, second-guessed by our teams and having second opinions given as a matter of course. And that's not always the easiest of negotiation to have. And you will only want to do that if you're a specialist in Bristol or South Wales or somewhere like that. You will only want to do that if you have respect and confidence in the team that you're dealing with in Birmingham, and we believe we have those teams. I mean, clearly there is employment directly associated with the facility. There is spin-off employment in specialist services around this trust and our partners. But more than that, Birmingham is the home of the Industrial Revolution. You know, it's a city which has had great industrial heritage, and now with proposals to move us more towards high-tech industry. And proton therapy is a classic high-tech treatment. It's particle physics research brought into the health sector. And there are all kinds of opportunities that could come from that. We don't know what they are, but this is a facility with at least a 20-year life, so we have plenty of time to explore those. I'd pick on three things, really. The first is the strength of our clinical teams, not just within UHB, but within our partners in the Royal Orthopaedic Hospital and Birmingham Children's Hospital. With those two partners and with our strength already, we are covering all of the critical patient groups, the critical clinical areas where we need real strength. So that's the first and most important thing I would say. Obviously we are in the middle of the country. We have great transport links. It's a very easy city to get to. Maybe this is not so important at this stage, but during the life of this facility, we will hopefully have high-speed rail links, which mean that the centre of Birmingham and North London is 45 minutes away. That's a very significant development. We're talking about a facility which will be opening in 5 years' time, then with a 20-year life. So transport links are essential. We have on-site accommodation. We have all of the facilities that the patients need. we have a lot. There are a long list of strengths to the Birmingham bid. I'm a medical physicist. I've been involved in physics research related to improvements in cancer treatment for some years. We're actually engaged now in a project where our partners are universities all around the country, developing technology which might be great for proton therapy, if the project works, in 15 or 20 years' time. But in doing that, we are already at the cutting edge of the skills needed for a proton therapy facility here. So we're already a long way up the learning curve. Proton therapy is a treatment for cancer using beams of protons. So these are nuclear particles. They're the nuclei of hydrogen atoms, and we accelerate them to very high energy in particle accelerators and then direct them at patients. What's very special about proton radiotherapy is that those proton beams, for a particular energy, have a defined range in tissue. So we can actually treat a tumour which is immediately adjacent to a critical healthy tissue by giving almost no radiation dose to that healthy tissue. So that's a great advantage. And that's very difficult to do with X-ray therapy. We can shape radiation fields very effectively with X-ray therapy. We can direct multiple fields from different angles. But what we are effectively doing is spreading the radiation dose over a large volume of normal tissue so that the immediate toxic effects are small. But we're always worried about long-term complications. So hopefully with proton therapy, we treat possibly without those long-term complications. One of the things which has brought attention onto proton radiotherapy in recent years is the need for children to go abroad for treatment. That's a very difficult thing to organise, and it's very painful for parents, obviously. With our partners in Birmingham Children's Hospital, we already have the second largest practice for paediatric radiotherapy in the country. We have all of the infrastructure in place to look after those patients. I would say, with the design of this facility, one of our intentions is to actually bring that paediatric care into our site. At the moment, we treat the patients here in UHB, but all of the care, the specialist clinician input, comes from the Children's Hospital and is delivered at the Children's Hospital. Within the proton therapy facility, we aim to have a satellite unit from Birmingham Children's Hospital on our site, where specialist care will be given to those patients and the patients having X-ray radiotherapy here in that facility. So for paediatrics, I think we've got a real strength. You may know that many children who come for radiotherapy, particularly the very young ones, will need anaesthetic every day during their treatment to help them stay in a still position during the treatment. Proton radiotherapy as well offers the possibility to treat patients which are even younger than we would normally accept for treatment now, because the toxicity is so low. So the damage that we do from the treatment is very low from proton radiotherapy. So we would consider giving that to even younger children. So having those established partnerships and the working anaesthetic teams, because actually the number of children who are needing anaesthetic could go up quite substantially, and clearly they need anaesthetic every day for the 20 or 30 days of the treatment. So that's quite a big demand on the anaesthetics teams. If you're trying to put that infrastructure in place, then you've got a lot of work to do. We already have it, but we will need to expand it. Well, if we focus on the adult population, we're relatively unusual in having a very strong clinical team looking at surgery of the tumours in the base of skull. Richard Irving's team is very strong, very well respected nationally, and it's a place where clinicians around the country, I think, would be happy to refer their patients. Not every large hospital has such a team, and we're quite special in having that. We also have a very strong neurosurgical team. Professor Cruikshank leads that area for us. Most large hospitals will have, specialist hospitals will have a neurosurgical practice. Most of them won't be as large as ours, and most of them perhaps won't have the headline figures leading our team, which have the reputation. So I think that's a very important point, because we're going to ask cancer treatment teams around the country to have their judgment, not exactly second-guessed, but looked at again by our teams in deciding on the optimum treatment for those patients. We won't just take a referral for proton radiotherapy. We'll take a referral of that patient to look at their whole package of care and to comment on what's been done. For example, it may be that our team will feel that more surgery is indicated before proton radiotherapy. And that will then involve a dialogue between the surgeons to decide where that's done, and obviously with the patient very much at the centre of that discussion. Getting good outcomes from proton therapy is not necessarily a given. It needs a very careful dialogue between the surgeons at the Royal Orthopaedic Hospital, between our cancer clinicians here at UHB, and our medical physics team, my team at UHB. The best outcomes will come by careful dialogue and exploration of all of the variables within that team. Well, that team is already here and is already working. We don't have to set that team up. We don't have to bring people in. That's a huge strength for us. Well, the proton therapy service in Birmingham, I think we're very lucky in the facility that we can put together. We have the site. We have a site which we can use very flexibly. We're not in a hurry to build on top of it. And we can put it directly next to our existing radiotherapy department. So we can capitalise on all the infrastructure that's already here. So we can therefore develop proton therapy in a step-by-step process to fit with the national need, to fit with what the NHS and the patients need. We're not determined to have the biggest facility in the world right from the start, but we can potentially evolve from 2 treatment rooms to 3 or 4 as the need dictates. And as we learn how to use proton radiotherapy in the best and most efficient way, we can perhaps expand the capacity of that facility, partly by learning just how to move patients through the treatment faster, which is a benefit to them and a benefit to us in trying to treat more patients, partly by extending the operating day of the facility and other technical means. So potentially we might start with a facility that can treat 500 or 700 patients per year. Over the life of the facility, that might double. I think what's most important, I think, is what the trust brings to this whole picture is a desire to be a research leader and the ability to make that happen. One of the things which is, I go around the country, speak to lots of people in different hospitals, our trust is unusual in some respects. It's very strongly managed, very strongly led, and that, providing you agree the direction that we're going, that's a great strength. We're all going together on proton therapy, but also with the formation of the Birmingham Academy, which bridges the university and the hospital and brings all of our research activity into an umbrella framework which is coordinated, then we're putting the infrastructure in place to be a research leader. Proton therapy will be a key part of that. Birmingham has been a home of high-tech industry for centuries. There is a lot of high-tech development in Birmingham, but it's a regional priority to bring more of that kind of industry to Birmingham. This is a very high-tech facility that we're putting together. We're bringing particle physics technology, research physics technology into the NHS, into cancer treatment. And there are all kinds of spin-offs. The proton beam that we will have available could be very useful for testing satellite components, for example, before they're put into space. It could be useful for our research teams within the university to test their experimental setup before they go to CERN or the big particle physics labs. It's not our priority. Treating patients is our priority, but it's something we will explore over the life of the facility.